Hello, Pisces. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, April 18th through the 24th, 2022, for all Pisces, suns, moons, risings, Pisces on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the 12th house or Venus in Pisces, you can watch this reading. Please do keep in mind these are general forecasts and they may not resonate with you specifically. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please do come get a personal private tarot reading with either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. For your reading today, we are using the Anna K. Tarot Deck by Anna K. Don't know the publisher on this deck. I know Anna K. She's also the illustrator. If you want more information, go ahead and Google the Anna K. Tarot Deck. I've also listed it below in the description. You could also try and find it on Amazon or your local bookstore if you're interested in purchasing. Oracle Cards, Wisdom of the Hidden Realms. Oracle Cards by Clyde Barron Reed. This is a Hay House product. If you want more information regarding the cover design, the illustration, or the cover illustration or cover art, there's a website there for you and some more information. All right. Pisces. Private readings. I do offer them if you'd like to book a personal private tarot reading with me. All my information is below in the description, including the website and scheduling page. There's also a Groupon link down there if you want to save up to 50% off my 30-minute live readings. Link up in the right-hand corner as well. If you want to book a private tarot reading with me, go ahead and click that link. I think I just saw your card, the Hangman there. Could be wrong. Let's see. Pisces. Take a deep breath there. I feel like you could be releasing some like heavy energy this week, or just something is being released. Intuitive messages coming through there. So also breathing exercises or just like meditation, yoga, breathing. Like what's it called? Can't think of the type of breathing. Anyway, underneath the deck we have Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Earth sign energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Yeah, someone's all stuck in their head here. Someone feels trapped like a victim. Someone is stuck and not moving forward. Someone is second guessing here. This could be someone you're dealing with, or this could be an aspect of you. We have Gemini here. I see Capricorn, Taurus. Yeah, what's keeping you stuck or someone's stuck? How do you see yourself today? High Priestess reverse. Not listening to your intuition. Hiding, withdrawn. This is also my hidden enemy card. So you see yourself as maybe a hidden enemy, or you see yourself as hiding or withdrawn, or maybe not wanting to show who you really are to the world. There could be many reasons for this, of course. You might only want to show someone what you think they want to see as opposed to who you really are. There's some secrecy involved with this energy. What is their theme this week? Wheel of Fortune. Big changes, big shift happening here. Growth, expansion, and change in a positive direction. Expect the universe to move you forward on your path here. Important that you go with the flow this week. There are going to be some big changes coming up. Very karmic energy. In the past, you learned a lesson regarding the star in reverse, Aquarius. This has to do with your faith, your hope, your optimism for the future. Very pessimistic energy when it's in reverse. Someone may have lost hope or faith, or someone was not on their north node here. This could be like a south node, past karmic situation. You might have been dealing with an Aquarius in your past as well. What is your challenge this week, High Priest? Your challenge is to do the right thing here. Teaching and learning coming to the forefront here. You could be dealing with a larger institution than yourself, like a bank, a church, or a school. We also have Taurus coming up again here. The High Priest really doesn't take anyone else's advice. He takes his own advice. That's why his ears are covered. Also, we have the keys here, so Master Keys. There's a challenge regarding learning a lesson here. There's a challenge regarding some kind of knowledge here, higher learning that you need to pick up here. What is the lesson you're learning now? The Sun in reverse. Interesting. Capricorn had the same card there. There's a lesson you're learning regarding your happiness, regarding letting your true nature shine. Also, someone could only be giving you half-truths here, or someone is dimming your light, or this could be a lesson you're learning regarding depression or feeling under the weather, burnout. Interesting, we have celestial bodies here, the star and the sun. Both are stars, actually. So there could be a lesson regarding astrology as well, or learning about a lesson regarding the solar system here, how we're all connected or how something is connected. Gift. King of Pentacles reversed. Someone is greedy, possessive, jealous, or two-timing. Someone is a workaholic. Someone here is two-timer. So with this energy here, this is, again, Earth sign energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, or Rising. I feel like someone is getting worse at something. Okay, I feel like someone is getting progressively more and more possessive, more and more stuck, more and more jealous. There's something here that's going in the wrong direction. We do have Taurus pretty highly aspected here. So, seems like there's a pretty major lesson here that you're learning, or someone is trying to teach a lesson here. I don't know if it's getting through, though. That's the problem. Because I feel like someone's stuck, or someone is, like, digging their heels in, is kind of how I feel. What is, like, your advice this week? Now, if the situation doesn't resonate with you, just flip it, okay, and make it the other person. Obviously, I'm not trying to offend anyone here. I'm just reading the cards. Let's see. What is your advice this week, Pisces? We have the resting tree and the dragon's stool. Dragon's stool. Sagittarius had that message come out. And their message was that they are being tested this week. So something is requiring your patience, your stillness. Someone needs to rest here. Someone needs a break from this conflict, this inner conflict. There's issues of morality here. I heard conscious desire, but it says conscious choice here. Okay, so there's some decision making here. They're saying let things settle, take a break. I feel like I'm also getting this message that it's time to go with the flow here. Things are being set into divine order. Got that in Aquarius's reading. With this full moon in Libra energy as well. Allow conflicts to resolve themselves naturally. Allow the universe to bring things back into divine order. This is what I have for you, Pisces. Thank you for tuning in.